hurts. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, man, I'm glad I'm only going for an hour because my brain feels like it's gonna explode. Like, it's bad. It got really bad in, like, the last half hour. I feel like I'm gonna throw up, man, but it's good, but it's fine. It's fine. I can hold out. I can hold out. It'll be fine. It's just a headache. But let's go and play some fucking... Oh, let's turn the music off, shall we? Dude, get out of the way! Jeez. Why did BizHawk go away? What the hell is going on here? Okay. Oot. Where is it? Oot Rando 4.0. Here we go! Please work. Jeez, what a violent intro. Okay, I'll just go with P5. Is it redundant? It's weird, like, I feel like it would be weird to say P5K 4.0. It's like, isn't the 5 already the version number? But there you go, we got the Zora, Sapphire, that's fun. Ooh, I like my tunic, very pretty. Very pleasant. Oh, that's not annoying at all. That's not annoying music at all. By the way, if the bitrate suddenly shits the bed in like an hour here, it's because I actually have my laptop upstairs with the with Nintendo Capri Sun's Twitch on, just to make sure that I don't technically miss any of the any playtime when he starts the Persona 5 stream tonight. A Deku Nut? That's not very interesting. Ugh. Clock Towel? That isn't very scary. 3 Skulltula tokens in the shop? That's good, I guess, because it's not important. How cheap are they? 165, 70, 85. That's not so bad. I can buy 2 of those without even needing to. Oh, that's annoying. Oh, it's like music to me. Oh, it's a symphony. I really like this tunic. This is really pleasant. It's very easy on the eyes. I would have waited until after Tim did his Persona 5 stream tonight. But I don't know when that would have. There's no telling how long it's gonna take him to beat the rest of the game. He's like halfway through the final part of the final dungeon. Oh my gosh, that's a great Navi sound. The pose laugh. What do we got? I don't think I turned on chest size matches contents. We got 50 rupees. I don't give a shit. Okay. As soon as this thing passes us by, we sneak around this way. We can almost afford one of those gold Skulltulas. Or one of those Skulltula tokens, rather. I'm not buying the gold Skulltula from the shop. That's just ridiculous. Excuse me. Okay, so we got Mido's house, we got the Kokiri sword chest. Lost Woods, we can get the Deku salesman. I can't get the Deku salesman, I don't have a shield. Did I shuffle the ocarinas? I forget. I hope I didn't, because that would be a pain in the ass if I did. What do we got? We get a Bloopy. Man. Jeez. I have, like, literally no way to defend myself right now, because I can't... Hyrule Field, South Grotto... Why can't I get... Oh, no, yeah, I can. I'm looking at the wrong dang thing. Let's go check some grottos. That one open grotto. Oh, nice Hyrule Field music. Something nice and low-key. Not the mini-boss music this time. I can already feel that headache going away, thank God. Hopefully it won't come back when Tim starts streaming Persona 5. It won't come back. I should make a new background for this, because, like, the first stream I did of that last seed... Why are there so many pea hats? What the heck? The first stream I did of that last seed, I had, like, a different background. It was all green, it was, like, Kokiri Forest textures, and now I have this Temple of Time background. I should have made a new background for the 4.0 seed, but I wasn't even sure I was gonna do it until, like... I don't know, a couple hours ago. I guess I could have done it, but I was too busy playing Minecraft. Jeez, man. There's the hole. Crack. What do we got? Can we just see? What do we got? It's a recovery heart. That's boring. Like, a draw? Well, that's boring. I love the way he says that in the Mario Party 2 LMAO series. He's just like, a draw? Well, that's boring. He says it, like, so fast. It's like in the Secret Koopa Kid comics when Smartball is like, what happened to the time warp? Jeez, that's better. they're in different panels, but Tim reads the two bits of dialogue so close together that it sounds like he's saying them in the same breath. Because the lights come back on so he can see better. It's like, what happened to the time warp? Jeez, that's better. I like streaming because I can talk with a little more stream of consciousness than I try to keep out of my LPs, like... Excuse me. Oh, man. That was foul. Hello, Rayjams. How's it going? Dude, would you get in my arms? Jeez. Don't you hate when you're trying to grab a Kuko when you just won't get in your arms? It's like, God, it's so annoying. Let's see if I can get both of these in one Kuko. I hate... This is one of the most annoying things in this whole game, is when you fuck up re-grabbing the Kuko. Yeah, I knew that. I knew that in the new version, they actually... Skulltula tokens and heart pieces actually show as the item they are now, which is just so awesome. That was something that I was hoping to happen, that I was hoping would happen for, like, ages. I'm glad they finally got it working. Oh, I'm glad that headache is going away. It's still there. I can still feel it. Right? This is a really nice tunic. It's nice and saturated, but, like, not too offensive to the eyes. It's very pleasant. Now, I wonder what this is going to be, because we can see it as soon as it pops up. It's a red rupee. Man, oh my gosh! Look how nice that looks. You never really get to see this model of the rupees normally, because normally when you pick up a rupee in the field, it's just like the little tiny ones, the little tiny models, the simpler models. But I always loved the way red rupees looked in this game when you get them out of chests. They just look so crimson. It's like, oh, it looks so good. It's like a sunstone or something. Splish! That was a really bad splish. Let me try that again. Splish! No, I'm not hitting the right note. Splish! Splish! Hello, Mad Hats. Kaboom! That's a bit easier to do. Because all you gotta do to do kaboom is, like, strain your voice as you do the boom! Oh, nice. Yeah. I didn't put much. This is a skull sanity and key sanity, full key sanity and skull sanity seed, so it'll probably be at this for a while if I decide to go all the way with it. I might maybe I can just become an Ocarina of Time rando streamer. you know, with occasional bouts of other things that aren't Ocarina of Time rando, because I read on Twitter the other day that for, like, people who are interested in investing in streamers, it's actually detrimental to you to label yourself as a variety streamer. Because although it's, you know, like, that it's kind of like a trade-off you have to decide to make, that it's easier for your channel to grow if you know exactly what you want, what you play, if you define yourself like that, you know? Because then people always know exactly what to get from you, and they know whether they want to check you out or not, and it makes sense. It's kind of disheartening, but it makes perfect sense to me. I saw people like disagreeing with a guy on Twitter, and I was like, I couldn't think of a reason to disagree. I couldn't think of a single refutation of the argument that having that looking at it like that, that, you know, locking yourself into one thing and that's the thing that you do on stream, you know, it makes sense that that would help you grow. Because what are you going to bet on in a horse race? The horse who runs, you know, 80 miles per hour every... Yeah, what are you going to bet on in a horse race? The horse that runs 80 miles per hour every single race? Or the one that runs 20 to 90 miles per hour randomly? You're probably going to bet on the 80. I don't even know if that's a realistic running speed for a horse. Probably not. I mean, 80 miles per hour? Good lord, that's like faster than a car. I don't actually know what, like... Because I've never driven, and I really don't want to, because I hate the idea of... I hate the idea of being responsible for a two-ton box, for a two-ton metal box, moving at speeds enough to plaster people against walls. It's all those fucking stupid-ass, god-awful PSAs they show in school. I tell you what, man. If I could meet with God and ask him to make one change to the world, like, it would be to make everybody conscious of the... To make everybody actively or passively, subconsciously conscious... of the... That, I know that's an oxymoron, but... Make everyone conscious of the risks of driving... Of driving a vehicle. And smite every single person who has ever made one of those gruesome car PSAs. Because those things are inexcusable. There's nothing I hate more in this world than those god-awful car PSAs. Well, okay, that's probably a lie. I can probably think of something I hate more than those car PSAs, but I mean, goddamn, is that really the best thing we have to teach people about the responsibility of controlling a vehicle? Showing them like an 8-year-old getting hit by a car right in front of her dad, you know, and then watching the dad in the hospital waiting room receive the bad news. Like, nobody wants to watch that shit. All that's gonna do, you know, it's gonna scare half the class straight and generate and give the rest of the class a freaking phobia of driving. But anyway. Good lord, I didn't mean to go on that rant for that long. Well, what even spurred that? Music in here. Fire Temple. Too bad you can't hear it over the fucking chickens. Good lord. It's so annoying. Let me tell ya. Oh, that guy's behind. That guy's behind the fence. Oh, I can feel that nausea coming back. I can feel it coming back. It's like a breeze coming in between your unzipped pants. Alright, disturb you. Excuse me. Oh, Ugh. Man, I should not have had that omelet earlier. That is a repulsive smell. Good gravy. So if I run slow enough, I can jump off and grab this thing. That is by far the most convenient way to do that I've ever found. And I just tried it for the first time right now. Jump off that roof and land there. And then you're set up perfectly. Because normally what I end up doing is throwing the chicken off the roof and then running over and having to pick it up again. So by jumping off the roof with the Cuckoo still in my hands, or the Cuckoo or whatever the fuck, and landing up there where that other chicken is, I like bypass the whole problem. It's killing three birds with one stone. It's getting that one on the raised fenced off platform. It's getting the one I used down to closer to where Anju is. Not Anju, but you know what I mean. And it's eliminating one extra throw and pick up of a chicken that I would otherwise have to. I guess you can just jump off without throwing it. So that's not really actually that much of a time save, because it's just stupid to do it in a way that would waste time. It's completely unnecessary. God damn it. Man, that takes away a whole heart. I hate jumping sideways off this tower. Like, I can't believe it works as often as it does, because when you move sideways when you're locked on, it's like impossible to actually move sideways. You always end up like going diagonally forward, and it just looks so stupid. Shit. Oh, that's annoying. Can I get a heart? Thank you. I ain't never missed this twice in a row. It's like the more I think about this, the worse I get at it. Also, is it just me, or is Link's animation weird when he's climbing up that ladder? I never noticed that before. Thank you. He gives me a go. Oh, you son of a bitch. So mad. Okay, so one of these fuck sticks is right here. Okay, so now I can hop up here. Give me the right camera angle, jump off like this, and I can grab onto the ladder. That's like the fastest way you can do that, by far. I've already forgotten. Oh, it's the sound of those, it's the sound of the Deku Scrubs after you hurt them, and they're standing there blinking blue in the room right before Queen Goma. So that's actually like a perfect fit, because normally when you hear that sound, it's every couple seconds anyway. When those guys are like sitting there stunned, waiting for you to complete the code, 23 is number one. You hear that sound. There's your dumbass chickens. A Skulltula token. Jeez, man. I gotta find a store that carries sticks, because I desperately need literally any way to fight. Like, I have nothing. I literally have nothing. I have money. Oh, I have Deku Nuts. I don't think Deku Nuts work on Gold Skulltulas. They might. I'm actually not sure. You know what I really need to get into the habit of? I need to get into the habit of actually reading the chat messages that before I reply to them. Because that's what Nintendo Capri Sun does. That's what everybody else does. They actually read the messages in chat before they reply to them. And it's like, of course, that makes a lot of sense. Because, you know, it makes it clear who you're, like, which host you're referring to. It sounds natural. I just can't get in the habit of it. I don't know why. It's because I spend so much time talking to myself that I don't want to waste time, you know, reading something again. It's like when you have to write a paper or do like an answer sheet in like an English assignment, and they ask you to write to do the answers in complete sentences, you know? That's what it's like. It's exactly like that. It's like, why did Jimmy do blank? That's the question. And, you know, the incomplete answer would be like, because... It's like, why did Jimmy do X? Because why? It's like, no, you're supposed to say, Jimmy did X because why? You know, you have to include a complete, you know, it's supposed to be a complete sentence. But nobody ever does that, because who cares, you know? It's an implied subject. See, what confuses me is, like, you have the subject of a sentence and the object. I think the subject is the first noun. It's like subject, verb, object, you know? It's like, I ate an apple. I'm the subject. Ate is the verb, and apple is the object. But what the fuck is it? Like, what is it about the words subject and object that dictates which one is the first noun and which one is the second noun? You know? Neither word has any root connotation for being, you know, former or latter. No, I is a pronoun, but pronoun isn't a part of a sentence. Pronoun is a type of word. I is a pronoun, but in the context of the sentence, it's the subject. That's like saying that Link isn't the hero of this game. He's a Hylian. It's like, what? I guess I'll buy a gold Skulltula token. I can get more money anyway. These are like the best shops to buy random crap at, because it's always easy to restock your money from here. Another gold Skulltula token, I tell ya. Compact. Oh, yeah, 25 rupees, that's not bad. Da-da-da-da! I'll buy a Deku stick, because it's one piece. I'll buy two of them. What am I doing? Oh, I should have done that before. I should have done that first. I should have done the fucking... I shouldn't have bought those Deku sticks. I should have played the fucking slingshot game. That's fine. You can get 20 rupees in here. And I'll just use save states. I don't give a shit. Well, sure, but you don't need a pronoun. The fact that Link is Hylian is not going to be relevant in every context where you would need to refer to him, so it's not that important, you know. In the context of the sentence, I ate an apple, it's not important that I is a pronoun. That's not relevant to the sentence structure. Oh my gosh, okay, where's the red rupee? I know there's a red rupee in here. Don't do me dirty like this. I know there's a red rupee in here. There's supposed to be a Yoshi. Where's that fucking Yoshi, man? Dude, get out of the way. Seriously. I'm just trying to eat my fish. He's falling off the plate. There's another green. I have enough rupees now from breaking open all these nothing pots. Y'all. There was nothing in that one. What a jib. Can you do that thing? No, you can't. I think there's some game where you can just roll through pots to break them, and it's like the most kick-ass thing ever. It's like, I wish I could roll through pots to destroy them. Like in Dark Souls. That one, or I think it's Bloodborne, actually, where the Grumps just, like, rolled through all the pots in a room. Okay. Okay, save state button.
Beep.
Now, this one's easier because it's always the same thing every time. Hello, fish. How's it going? Come on. Shitty ass aiming. Okay, now just don't fuck this up. Fuck yeah. Okay. Oh, wow. Boy, I'm glad I did that. Glad I thought of it. Sorry. I just can't stop thinking about that quote. Anytime I say glad I blank, I think of that quote from the Super Mario World cartoon. When someone gives Bowser the idea to hypnotize the cave people with television, he's like, good idea. Glad I thought of it. It's just so stupid. This is very similar to the music that played in here last time. Deep Forest, Immense Cavern. Okay, that's the same. One in P5K4.0's pocket. What a ridiculous name. Well, who cares? It's like, that's crazy. Especially since, who cares? Okay, so I got Anju's chickens. I got the grotto chest. I didn't get the heart piece. Hello, particle. I don't know if you guys saw the announcement, but I'm only going to be going for like another half hour because Tim starts his last Persona 5 stream in about half an hour. So, and I have a headache anyway, so. Yeah, you know what, I'm going to go back to Kakariko Village, get all the chests I can get before I go become an adult. Because it's not necessary to talk about it tonight, it's late, scoot off to bed now. Well, shucks, don't I feel honored. I should start watching more of Liam Six's stuff. He's a pretty cool dude. That was the idea I had, Ray Jams. Because it's like, you know, I really want to get into the habit of streaming on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and the calendar is really helping. I knew it would, and you know, turns out it absolutely did. But the point that I was trying to make is that because Tim decided that he was too excited for the end of Persona 5 to wait another week to end it, you know, I wound up in the awkward position of, you know, having a stream at 7 p.m. Central to mod today, but also, you know, having my own pseudo obligation to stream today as well. You know, it's like, I too will, ha-ha. For I think it's funny as well. But anyway. I should wait for night. I can get into the, no, I can't get into the, I cannot get the cow heart piece at night. Because I need the chicken. I wonder what it'll be. You know what I could do, actually? I could actually go into that house and look and see if it's worth picking up. Because of the 4.0 version shows, like, when a heart piece or a gold skull Tula token isn't actually one of those things, it actually shows it now before you pick it up, which is just so awesome. I can't wait to kill a gold skull Tula and see, like, a bloopy appear. That would make picking up bloopies actually, like, enjoyable. I also really like it because it gives you a good an opportunity to get a really good look at the fancier rupee models in this game, which are just so fucking cool looking. A small key. Well, I should definitely pick that up. Man, and in the base game, they always use like they use this little piddly ass 2D picture for a small key, and here they got it working all good. Like, I don't even know. My brain is fried. It's gonna be really fun. Well, the nice thing about Persona 5 is that we're pretty much past all the plot twists now. So, like right now, all there is to do is go fight the final boss and then watch the ending, pretty much. That was like perfectly timed. No! Get you piece of shit! If you hadn't locked onto him like a dipshit, we would've been just fine. Get back here, you fuck. Persona 5 randomized would absolutely not work. I mean, I guess you could, but it wouldn't work in any meaningful, way. Basically, all it would do is shuffle around the enemies and, like, the equipment. It wouldn't change the actual game. All it would do is make it a little bit different. Okay, would you just... Oh, you dumbass. You didn't get a big enough jump because you were too close to the edge. Shut up, Navi. Creepy-ass Navi. Oh man, now I want to draw like a spooky ghost girl Navi. That would be so cool. Sorry, the way I said that, it was just like so obvious that that my brain was trying to come up with a different word, and then I said cool. Fucking awful, those burps, dude. They just, so disgusting. Ugh. Like, and I've had some bad tasting burps, but those are like on a whole new level. I haven't really eaten much today, have I? Because I felt sick all day since I had like slightly wilted lettuce with Russian dressing for breakfast. And apparently, like, lettuce has this thing where it, like, releases nitric acid as it's digested, which is, like, a chemical that, for, like, ages, scientists thought was straight-up toxic, but now it turns out that pretty much all green plant matter releases it as it's digested. So, what was I saying? So basically the idea is that, like, if you eat lettuce, you're gonna feel nauseous for a while as it digests, because it's basically, you know, it's putting this nasty shit into your stomach as part of the, I don't know, how many times can I fucking say as part of the digestion? As part of the it's like, what the fuck is that word, or that quote, where someone says digestion, but they say it like, oh, that's the Game Grumps Trauma Center, when they're like, the digestive track. More like the disgusting process. But that doesn't work because it's not the same G sound in those two words. Absolutely digesting. Yeah, no kidding. Okay, you know what I think I can do here? I think I can give this guy a whack. If I stand up here, I can give him a whack with a Deku stick, and that'll kill him in one hit, which will be nice. Ugh. And we get a red rupee. Hooray, that's so interesting. And we lost the Deku stick still, but we got the glitch, but we didn't really have anything we could use the glitch to do. It's like, that was such a tricky thing to do. Oh, let's do Dompei's grave digging tour. I forgot about this. It's a Deku stick! Man, it looks good all rotating around. That actually makes me excited to see a Deku stick when it's so, you know, it makes me excited to see anything, just to see the 3D model you would normally hold up actually just there on the ground. It's really cool. But anyway. We got a gold skeletal token. Did it actually say in the text how many I have in total? That is so cool. I didn't know it did that, and that must be in this version, because I would remember that if that was if that was like a thing. I wonder if it's possible to get Twitch notifications on your desktop, because I would totally do that. That's like the one thing that I would actually, that's like one level type kind of notification that I would actually appreciate getting, you know, like a Twitch desktop notification, because I've missed streams that Tim did before because he did them on an odd day, like the one he did, like the Contra stream he did to as a memorial to his mom. I missed that stream because he did it on a Monday, and also, for some reason, every single mod that visited the stream forgot to announce it in the Discord. It's like, jeez, man. Let me tell you something, I was fiery mad. I was fiery Bowser. Down by digging, shield grave chest, cow heart piece. I can't do Talon's chickens. I can't do that. But you know what I can do? Is I can go to Lon Lon Ranch and get the heart piece there. And we'll get to see what it is. Which is exciting. You can see me smiling as I got him. And maybe next time we stream this, probably, I don't know, maybe next Wednesday. Maybe I should just do like Oot Rando Saturday or something. And then we can just do whatever on Wednesday. I don't know, though. I mean, I guess if you do a variety stream, like, I mean, isn't that what Proton John does? And he doesn't have any trouble maintaining a huge community. Although, I guess the thing about him is that I think he gets his viewers to, like, vote on every stream he does, like, whether it's gonna be game clearing, or... Oh, it's, like, up on top of the sign, isn't it? No, it's there. Whether it's gonna be like a game clearing stream or a fortune cookie or whatever the other options are. I think there's like one other option that I don't remember. Yeah. I think about that sometimes too, and it's sad. Yeah, it's rough when you have such a small audience that, like, there's not enough people who, you know, value their opinion so much that they want to. Oh, right, they sped up the box pushing and pulling and shit. That's nice. Like, I guess I did a vote for my 50 follower game between like Breath of the Wild, Dark Souls, and Hollow Knight, and I didn't end up doing any of them. I ended up doing Dark Souls 3, kinda. I streamed it twice, and then I wonder how many followers I have. I don't think I've ever looked at it. I can't remember the last time I actually. Let me look. I'm curious. How many Twitter followers do I have? No, come on, you piece of junk. Dude, followers. 49? Jeez. Thought I had more than that. I mean, I wouldn't. You definitely do seem to be more connected on Twitter than I do. than I am. Okay, I got that. I got the child shooting gallery. I can't get the dog lady. Well, actually, no. Actually, yeah, I can. I could get the dog lady if I just waited in the, if I waited in the courtyard. In the castle courtyard. I didn't get anything in there because the game thinks that I can get a shield, but I can't because I have Shop Sanity on. I don't remember when I started using Twitter seriously, but there was a point where I just started paying attention to it, and I never really stopped. I just started making sure that I always had Twitter open, and ever since then it's like, you know, it's definitely useful. You know, as long as you follow people you actually want to listen to, you know. But that's the most important thing, is that you have to curate your own experience with the platform. You can't expect Twitter to make your... You can't expect Twitter to make your experience good for you. You have to... You know... A recovery heart. A compass! Jeez. That huge compass violently appearing is so shocking. Oh, well, you know what? No, I looked in the shops. Yeah, I did. I can't get up to any of the, I think I'm pretty much done. Or out of... No, you know what? Here, hang on. Yeah, I've actually been debating, like, possibly unfollowing Proton John because I don't watch his streams. And it's like, every time he streams, there's like a waterfall of retweeting every... Of just retweets that I have, like, no context for. You know? But at the same time, it's like... Other than that, I enjoy his tweets, so it's like, well, what do you do? Like, I'm sure there have been things that I wouldn't have checked out if it weren't for a retweet from him. Like, the Messenger? I don't know. I mean, I guess I probably learned about the Messenger. I think I became interested in the Messenger because of Gaijin Goomba. And, the Completionist. The Completionist is a huge fan of the Messenger. I can't wait for that. Is it a free update? There's DLC for the Messenger coming. It's like actually like a beach episode. Like it's like a mini campaign and it's a beach episode. And I cannot wait. That game is so freaking good. I should LP it. That might be a fun thing to stream or LP. Cause I haven't really seen many LPs of that. It seems like people really sleep on that game. Like, Hollow Knight, you get LPs and blind streams of that left and right, but it seems like, despite, like, people like The Completionist and Gaijin Goomba, and I think Proton John even played it and enjoyed it, it seems like nobody ever talks about The Messenger. And it's a really good game, you know? It's a very good game. I can't see the sun anymore, game. You can turn off the lens flare. I can't see the sun anymore. Oh, I know the feeling, Particle. Like, recently I watched a video from an old guy, from an old YouTuber named Homestar Runnertron. I rewatched one of his old videos and left a comment, like, with a bunch of my favorite quotes. And within 5 minutes of posting the comment, I got a notification saying he'd subscribed to me on YouTube. And I was like, what? That can happen? Alright, let's go use my newfound knowledge that this is always Richard to, complete the side quest nice and quick. I can't believe I never knew that, like, I always thought it was random, you know? Like, I could have sworn I had picked a different dog and gotten the gotten a reward. We get a heart. What do you fucking do? Oh, such garbage. Dog lady. Oh geez, I forgot that like I can actually go into the Deku Tree. Earlier I like didn't go into the Deku Tree because I forgot that you don't actually need the sword and shield to get in there in the randomizer. Because Mido is out of your way. Mido. It's like Titus versus Titus, even though Titus is the canon pronunciation. I will never accept it because there is no thematic reason to pronounce it like that. His whole thing, Final Fantasy X, has water motifs off the wazoo, so why is it not pronounced like tide? It's like, geez, man. Wait, seriously? It's actually only playing one part of... It actually shuffled the song into her spot. It actually shuffled a totally different song into Malin's singing, and it's only playing a certain part of the... Oh, that's cool. Alright, Dave, you can come any second now. And that purple sky. What even color is that? It's like lavender. It's like the color of lavender hair product bottles or something. I'm gonna run back to Kokiri Forest. It's probably gonna take the rest of the time we have to stream because we only got 10 more minutes until 7. And then I gotta bounce, because I gotta mod that last stream, and I also need to see the ending. I've never actually seen the ending for that game. I knew generally what happened the whole way through, but I've never actually seen anybody play all the way through Persona 5. So it's gonna be really weird to actually watch the ending, because I have no idea what happens. I literally don't know what happens in the ending to Persona 5. Like, I know up to the final boss, and I know how the final boss fight goes, and I don't know anything after that. Oh, get out of the fucking way. Alright, let's go get the chests that we actually can get in the Deku Tree, which is like one chest, I think. Maybe two. Ugh. Like, we can get the one in the... We can get the one in the main trunk area. We can get one chest. We can't go into the room with the Deku Scrub because we'll get stuck because we don't have a Deku Shield. We can climb up past the Skulltulas carefully, but obviously we need to be very careful doing that. And also, if I lose this Deku Stick, I won't be able to get out of the ensuing room, but if I get up there, I can also jump down and break the cobweb, so I can get, like, 3, maybe 4 chests. Depending on what I get out of these chests. If I get more Deku Sticks, like a Deku Stick upgrade, that'll open things up considerably. It'll allow us to get a couple more Skulltulas for sure. What do we got? We got a key! It's like I have 12 fucking keys. Gotta be very careful here. Man, they didn't see me at all. I'm Solid Snake, baby. That was a stupid laugh. Why is there so much spider web at the top of this place? Jeez, this is worse than, like, I love this Navi sound. It makes me imagine her as, like, some kind of, like, spooky ghost fairy, like, with, like, a melty mouth. Like, like Miss Deli. Oh, jeez. What do we got? Alright, there's actually more chests in here. Oh, bomb chews. Nice. That actually, that is a great find. We do have Deku seeds, too. Heck! There we go. Don't get bot. No, you can. No, I can use a bomb chew. A blue pea. Bob. Yeah, use a bomb chew. Can I? Okay, hang on. Let me try this. No, it doesn't do anything. Okay. Hey, Miss Deli wasn't specifically a Void Enterprises thing. That was like a. That was actually a Gold Skull. That's boring. That was like an Isaac community in general thing. I wonder if people still draw Miss Deli porn. Like on the Rule 34 subreddit. I've actually never really looked. But I wonder if it still happens. Okay, but anyway. Get fucked. Ow. That did a whole heart of damage? Jeez Louise, man. That hurt. Huh. So happy. Ooh, it's 6:56. Man, that's so lame. It's like a fucking rupee, like, seriously. Is that the best you can come up with? Oh, damn, a quiver upgrade. That looks so cool with the item actually floating there. I love it, man. Okay, now, is there a surefire way to get this up there? Nope. Maybe if I... Not even if I hook this up a little. Oh, you know what I can do? Here, I got an idea. I can send a bomb chew down from above. That'll be much easier to aim. And then I can drop down and pick it up. Assuming it doesn't, like, disappear or despawn or something. It might actually. I don't even know. I know you can get this by, like, doing a jump attack. Oh, if I had just been a little bit faster, that can totally work, but I need to get down here faster. I need to make sure that Gold Skulltula loads in before the Bomb Chew goes past it. And I have to do it fast because I only have 3 minutes. I only have 3 minutes before Persona 5 starts. Ah! You should draw Ghost Girl Navi. Draw like a spooky Navi. Drowsy with handsome Squidward. Jeez. Yeah! And it's a key. Oh. Well, that's nice. Well, I think I may as well head. Maybe here's what I'll do. I'll head back to the Temple of Time, and I'll turn into an adult. And then we'll end the stream. And we'll probably raid with, like, I don't know, hashtag spooky Navi or something. Okay, bye, Yosh. Okay. I hate when I try to turn the camera and I lock onto an enemy. It's like, God, it's so annoying. I wish I could play. You know what I wish they would do? And this would, like, never happen, because, like, there's no way it would be able to. Hey, does this work? Oh, I don't have that map, I don't think. But I think one of version 4.0's new things is that you can is that you can, like, you can map things to the D-pad, and I've never really tried that. Let me see if I can do that. I'll worry about that later. I have too many things mapped to too many buttons right now to fiddle with that. But I've seen, like, a little... They even have, like, a little GUI element that looks pretty nifty. See if I can make it back to town before night falls. Otherwise, I'd have to wait, like, an extra 5 minutes, and I don't want to do that, man. Oh, come on, make it. Come on. Yeah, we're fine. Ooh. Oh, stretch. Ah. Nice music in here. I didn't mention it before, but the ice cavern is always a pleasant track. It's a bit sharp, maybe, the fire temp or the ice cavern music, but it's still nice. Oh, here, let me, lobby chest, compass, room, side chest, basement chest. I can't get into the slingshot room. Oh, I think that's the, I think that's the notification on Discord that the stream has just started. So you better become an adult and then end the stream real quick. Somebody post hashtag spooky navvy in chat so that I don't have to, so that I can focus on hurrying up and picking a raid target. Yeah, I'm that lazy. I'm in that much of a rush. I need somebody else to write 10 letters and an orthogram. Man, that tunic is nice. Oh, it's just the boots and the ocarina on the D-pad. Okay. You silly beans. Hashtags, raid messages need capital letters, but fine. All right, well, raid with hashtag spooky nabby. I think Tim is live. Let me see. Yep, he's not. He's live. We gotta go. Okay, close the following tab. Exclamation mark raid. Thanks for coming out, guys. I know this was a bit of a short... Oops. raid Nintendo Capri Sun. Also, it's not an exclamation mark, chump stick. Thanks for coming out, you guys. I know it was kind of a short dick video, or a short dick stream, but maybe next time will be a long dick stream. So that'll be fun. Anyway, bye! Yep. Yeah.